I love the springs. I've been to most of the springs in this area. They're a lot of fun. It's always hot during the summer, so you jump in the freezing water. It's a great mix. You can snorkel. There's alligators all over the place. It's just a great place to come hang out.
It's something that's special that Florida has that no other place has, this kind of stuff. So we like to come here, and we like to go to all the springs, but this is one of the favorite ones for the kids.
A lot of people come to Central Florida for the attractions, and you know, Mother Nature has this beautiful swimming pool for us.
We've been here many times, and this place is kind of special because there's so much nice stuff to do outside, and it's kind of like a water park that Disney would want to make but couldn't pull off. I mean, you look around at the way the lazy river type thing is here and the way you float along, and the stuff that's on the side is all real and living. If you tube down this, it looks one way, but whenever you go under the water, we bring our snorkel mask. It's like a totally different thing underneath, and the water propels you down. You see little things that are cut into the banks that you can kind of swim under if you want to. We get to chase fish underwater. It's just a blast to spend a day here.
Well, I like to jump in first. No snorkel, no flippers, nothing. I have a few beers. I jump in and just enjoy the water. The freezing water sort of invigorates you. And I don't know, it triggers chemicals in your brain or something, and you just start to relax.
The water is the perfect temperature for a hot summer day. It will cool you off very nicely. You may not even need the air conditioner on the drive home.
And then after I lay around for a little bit in the sun and stuff, then I usually make my way back up to my area, have something to eat, and then I'll bust out my mask and snorkel and swim right down in the hole.
Like snorkeling in a fish tank. The water is crystal clear and you get a really good view of everything that might swim by. You've got a chance to see fish and turtles.
You can swim right down and see right where the water comes right up out of the earth, the freshest water you can imagine. And you know, it goes down really deep, so you can see how far you can swim down, and you kind of scare yourself a little bit, because at a certain point you can like turn under the rock, but you don't want to go down there because you might die. So it's fun, and you can't do that at the beach.
But this is really a unique experience to be able to just float down this, to propel yourself down this underwater. At that spring head where we start up there, if you dive in there, the rocks are all hollowed out underneath from the water current. So if you swim down, it's like you're in a tunnel underneath there, but you still have the ability to get out, so you don't really need like scuba gear or anything like that. So it's just a blast.
I think it's a great place to go, especially if you're not near the beach. Growing up in Miami, there was always a beach nearby. I didn't go to springs that often. And I came to school at Central Florida, and the springs were always nearby, and that's how I sort of got introduced to them. And I mean, they're a great time.
You know, you come to Florida for the beaches, but you've got salty water and big waves. And if you want to really relax, come to the springs and get cooled off in a very relaxing way.
My first reaction is no one should come, so that I can have it all to myself. But yeah, I mean, if you want to have a good time, when I'm not here, more people should come for sure.